Hi there, I'm Jamie Anderson, and this is Songwriting 101. I'm going to give you beginners a crash course in writing a song. I've written a couple hundred songs. I've put out 11 albums. I've also been teaching songwriting since 2000, so I've helped a lot of people do this, and I can help you. Now, keep in mind that this is a quick overview. If you want to know more, please contact me for Skype lessons. So let's get started. First of all, I want you to listen to some of your favorite songs and realize what it is you like about them. Okay? Dismiss the emotional content of it. So if that song was playing when your beloved first walked across the room and you saw her and you knew that you wanted to be with her forever, that is not a reason. Because that's not something you're going to be able to convey to an audience. They're not inside your head, which might be a good thing. I don't know. What you want to do is think in terms of melody and lyrics. Is there a really great story in the song? Do you like that they repeat one line and that it's really catchy? That's called a hook. Do you like how the melody goes up in the chorus? Do you like that it's in a minor key but it's a happy song? There's all kinds of reasons to like a song, so think about those kinds of things when you set out to do your own songwriting. Second, you need some ideas. Now, lots of people write about love lost and love gained, and that's all well and good, but there's millions of songs about that. And there's so much more you can write about. I once wrote a song about potato chips that was played on Good Morning America, and they paid me a boatload of money for it. Just because I like potato chips. It's a song I whipped out in a half hour. So carry around a notebook or type ideas into your phone. I know somebody who calls himself and leaves a voicemail. Those are especially good for melodic ideas. You can record on your phone, of course. You can get ideas by eavesdropping on conversations. Especially kids. Kids have some really great ideas. You don't want to tell me a story and not have it end up in a song. I mean, I do try to protect people's anonymity, but so I don't use names and addresses unless I'm really mad at you. But, you know, you can use your own life as inspiration, the people around you. I mean, there's a million stories going on all around us. So you want a whole bunch of ideas. Now, three, when you sit down to write a song, you've got that whole phone full of ideas, that whole book full of ideas, and now you've got a place to start. Here's one way that you can do it. Now, a lot of people think that you have to know music theory and have to be able to write notes and everything else to write songs. You don't. Maybe if you write classical music or if you write jazz, you do, but for our purposes, you don't have to do that. Take a song that you already know and write new lyrics to it using one of those song ideas. For instance, the answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. Now, if I was going to write new words for that, from my cat's perspective, here's what she might sing. The answer, my friend, is in that tuna can. The answer is in that tuna can. I just made that up. A little corny and kind of stupid, but it'll get the juices flowing. So sing whatever comes to your mind based on those ideas that you've got down. Now, keep in mind, because Dylan has already written Blowin' in the Wind, you can't record or sell that song. However, it's a good framework. After you do new words to that existing lyric and to that existing structure, then you can change the chords, you can change the melody, and voila, you've got a new song. Another thing that you can do is come up with a chord progression on your own. Doesn't matter what instrument you play, and it doesn't even matter if you know what chords you're playing. You can just make up some chords. So I'm going to continue on the guitar. I also play ukulele, mandolin, and a bunch of other instruments. If you play piano, all those instruments are really great for songwriting. So first you need to find a chord progression that you think is pretty cool. So I'm going to play G, A7, no, A minor 7, and then D. And I'm going to play that over and over again. So G, A minor 7, D. And I'm going to start thinking about what melodies that might inspire. It could be la, 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 la. I could think about about, do I want long notes or do I want short notes?
La, 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 la.
Do I want short notes?
La, 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 la.
Now what if my cat was going to write this? Give me tuna, I really need some tuna. Give me tuna now, meow. Again, kind of corny, but it'll get the juices flowing, all right? So once you get a chord progression that seems pretty good for the verse, think about the chorus. Now you don't want to use the same chord progression for the chorus. I'm going to reverse the chords for the chorus. G, A minor 7. Here's my cat. I am starving, oh, I am starving. Where is that tuna can? Again. Silly, but it'll give you an idea of how to come up with things off the top of your head. Now, don't edit while you write. Just barf it out, write it down, then you can go back to it and fix whatever you want to fix or toss it out and just consider it a good exercise, because like any muscle, your writing muscle needs to be exercised. Keep in mind that some of the greatest songs ever written didn't have lyrics at first. When the Beatles were writing Yesterday, they sang Yesterday. No, they didn't. They sang scrambled eggs, da 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 da, scrambled eggs. Okay? And then once the melody was set, then they started writing the lyrics to that song. So keep in mind that you could write the next Yesterday this way. Now, like I said in the beginning, this was meant as a quick overview. So if you want more help with your songwriting, I'd be glad to help you via Skype lessons. I'll put the address somewhere here in this frame. You could go to jamieanderson.com, and right there on the title page is a way that you can contact me. Also, I would love it if you'd listen to my songs. Jamieanderson.com is where you find out more about my work. And I'd love to hear from you. Thanks a lot.